Hello, you are watching Current Waves, full of entertainment. If you didn't yet subscribe our channel, then don't waste time and click on the subscribe button. Today I have much surprising video for you, so watch till end. 6 tips for success in Dirt 4. Racing games might be common, but the skills required to master the loose surface, unpredictable weather and narrow roads of the rallying world are very different to those that work on F1 tracks or street circuits. To give you the best possible chance at quickly being able to climb the top of the podium, we have come up with a number of key skills and ideas designed to speed up your learning and adapt to the challenges offered here. Dirt 4 includes a driving school mode entitled Dirt Academy that is there to teach you basics of braking, throttle control. But the actual mechanics of driving can only take you so far. In a game that can be unpredictable and unforgiving, these tips will put you in the right mindset before you even begin. So let's go for 6 tips for success in Dirt 4. Number 1. Start with a rally. Aside from traditional rallies, Dirt 4 also offers the more modern land rush and rally cross disciplines. Both of these modes are very different to a rally in terms of setup. But the core racing skills and vehicle management are, for the most part, transferable. As such, it makes sense to begin your Dirt 4 journey by seeking to tame the rally side of the game. This is the most technical and challenging element in terms of controlling the car and keeping it in perfect track position. And practicing these skills stands you in good stead for avoiding an opponent in other available types of racing. If you can master the snow in Sweden and the rains in Wales, then you can rest assured that you will be able to tackle pretty much anything. Number 2. Choose Wikigame as your first destination. Straight out of the gate, you have the option to indulge in rally stages located in Australia, Spain, Sweden, Wales and the USA. It's the USA with stages taken from rural Wikigame that represents the best starting point to get the grips with the rules of the road and your chosen car's performance. Michigan trails are slightly wider than most of those featured in other areas of the world, and there's much less to worry about when it comes to frequency of hairpin turns, blind corners and trackside obstacles. There are trees positioned all around you, but they are far enough from the track edge that you can remain safe as long as you are paying attention. From here, you can test yourself across the other countries. Number 3. Listen as well as look. For anyone already well versed in rally games, this will be second nature to you. But for the newcomers, get used to relying on ears just as much as you do your eyes. Your co-driver does a great job of calling out what's coming up in terms of corners, including how sharp they are, jumps, obstacles and other dangers. Listening to them and getting used to absorbing information quickly and accurately is key to setting fast times, particularly on tracks that features lots of blind corners and dangers hidden on the other side of high bumps and jumps in the road. The co-driver typically calls out what's coming up 2 to 3 corners in advance, so get in the practice of making a mental map of the course in your head using only their description. Number 4. Don't play fair in rallycross. If you are not bumping your opponent in rallycross, then you are not driving properly. Controlled aggression is par for the course in a discipline that features 4 cars racing over a number of short laps. The winners usually the one not afraid to make regular vehicle contract. Of course, but you don't want to go overboard to the point that you are putting your own race at risk or purposefully flipping your yellow competitor, but you certainly do want to use every inch of drag. If that means sideswiping someone as you are drifting through a corner, then so be it. Number 5. Understand the Rallycross Joker Lap. In each 4 lap Rallycross race, you must perform a Joker Lap once per session. This involves taking a detour from the usual route across an extra part of the track designed to slow you down. Test your technique and increase your lap time. Timing is everything when it comes to performing your Joker Lap. Number 6. Save your headlights. If you are racing in Sweden at night with snow under your wheels and heavy rain on the windscreen, then the absolute last thing you want to do is find yourself without headlights. Any knock into a trackside pile of snow and ice or nearby trees has the potential to dramatically reduce your already compromised visibility and ruin any chance of getting onto the podium. Of course, you need to weigh the up-risk-reward proposition of driving fast against driving with a view to keeping your electronics healthy and fit for purpose. Make use of any and all practice sessions you are afforded before taking to the track proper with the intent to setting a time, even if that means jumping out of a competition to race the course in free-to-play. So friends, this video was about 6 tips for success in Dirt 4. If you like our video, don't forget to click on subscribe button. I will meet you in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.